Hi guys, a very good morning to all of you. And see, again I am back here to teach you Standard 3, Chapter 9. And the chapter name is The View from My Balcony. It's lecture number 2. So in first videos, we have learned that there is one little girl. She's just telling this story that how the looks from her balcony. Then that was the month of June. And the sun is still bright in the sky. Then she is standing in her balcony with her grandmother, who is reading a magazine. And from her balcony, she can see a two-lane roadside. She just explained that on the right side there are two people on bicycles, rickshaws, and motorcycles, and in cars. But on there are three passengers, but the rickshaw's puller, he's pushing, he's giving his effort to push that rickshaws with that passengers. Then she just said that when she's going to ride, she always just take a ride on the rickshaws only when she's go to nearby the bazaar with her mother. But when she goes with father, she always takes car. And whenever she went with her grandmother, then she walks because her bones has weak, so he can't climb or rickshaws. That's why she always walk. And then she saw there is a big green bus. You can see in page number 103. That between the bus busy traffic, and she is just looking that some people are sitting and many more people are standing, and many people are standing inside the bus. And she is always wondered that how people they can stand on the bus without falling each others. Then she took a ride on the bus. She just remember that she took the bus ride first time with her mother, and that bus was very hot and crowded. Then on that day she was seated, but she was still quite uncomfortable in that bus. But She likes taking a bus ride and imagine herself to be on a ship with a wind that coming on her face. Next is, we will see from the page number 104 that there are a few pedestrians who are waiting to cross the road at zebra crossing. And we know that we have to cross always on the zebra crossing road. So there is some pedestrians are there. Pedestrians means the people who walking in the street. So they are waiting to cross the road at the zebra crossing, so that the cars and bus will stop. Then the person who will walk in the streets, they will pass her road that from the zebra crossing. They will cross the road when the traffic signal is red, and the pedestrians, they will cross the road from one to another path when the traffic signal it becomes red. So red, it means what? And it's safe for them to cross. And if the traffic signal is red, then it is safe for the pedestrians that they can cross the road. Because once the red means what? It's stop. So if any vehicles will come, then they will stop, and the pedestrian, they can move from the zebra crossing. A woman with a toddler is also waiting to cross the road. So a woman is also there. She's just waiting to cross the road. She has to hold his arm to stop him from running ahead of her. Then see what? She has to hold his arm that she can stop him from running ahead of her. Means that she has to stop that all the vehicles till that the all person will not cross the road. Across the two-lane road is the metro station. After across that, when we will cross the road of two lane, there is a metro station. We can hear the announcements from the station all through the day. So if we, because we, our, like our house is near to the station, metro station. So she can hear all the announcements that from the stations all every day and every time in a day. When it was new, I would run to the balcony every time. I would hear the horn which marked the arrival of the train on the station. When the metro train was new, then I was very excited and I run to the to my balcony every time when I heard when I heard the sound of horn and the make and incident to arrival the train on the station so that I can see the view of the metro train. However, now that it's a part of our life, so for so many years, it doesn't excite me anymore. So now it's a part of our life and it we have done it for so many years. So now we don't have any excitement. Like suppose you have to do some work every day. So the first day you will very excited because yes, it's a new day, that new something that you have to do first time, so that's why you will excited. But when you will do that work regularly, then you don't have that excitement on every day when whether it was the first day when you are excited. Then my house is on the curb of the road. Then her house is what? It is on the edge of the raised path at the side of the road. In the evening, the curb becomes a mini food street. So in the evening time, that the road, it becomes the mini food store, the small food store street. People make hot jalebis and chaat on their pashkards. Then people in the evening, the people what they make the hot jalebis and chaats and then they sell to the people. I like to watch the man. Is a checked shirt and slightly big tummy shoved the golgappas to people with swift movements of his hands. Then she just excited, the little girl, she just watched the man who is just wearing the checked shirt, whose stomach is like a big tummy, and he's serving the golgappa to the people with his hand, with the movement of his hand. When you will go in front of the golgappa shop, then you will see that man, he is just serving the golgappas from his hand. Then she is also excited to see that from her balcony. I love eating jalebis, hot, juicy and sweet smelling jalebis straight out of the kadhai. Then she just loves to eat the jalebis like a hot, juicy, and it is smelling when it's come out from the kadhai. I ask Granny if I can buy some from the man who sells it on the streets, but Granny says that she will ask Father to bring some from near his office when he come back from his home. Then when she is asked to his grandmother, her grandmother, that she can go and she can buy that jalebis from the streets, then grandmother said that you can ask first of all your father and then he will bring jalebis from the shop near his office when he will come back from his home at home. It's time for grandmother to have her evening tea and mother is calling me back inside to have milk with sandwiches while the elders have tea. Then now it's the evening time and it's time for the grandmother to take a evening tea and then after the mother, my mother will call me back to drink milk and to eat some sandwiches and then the elders will have the tea in the evening time. I look out one more time to see the sun looking like an orange candy with the streaks of orange and purple in the sky, covering the many people on the lane with its facile orange blanket. Then she is also very excited and she is also very happy to look one more time when sun is when sun is set down, then she is very excited to look that sky. It's look like an orange candies and like a purples. And when the people it's covering, the many people is covering the lane with its special orange blankets. So here is few words is there and your chapter has completed. I hope you guys had understood the chapter. If you don't, then please read the chapter once again. And please watch the videos 2-3 times. And please stay at home. And here is few words. You can write down words from meaning. Till that, take care of yourself. Again, I will be back to teach you the next chapter. So please protect yourself and your family. Till that, take care of yourself. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.